Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, I'm gonna show you how to use fasting, one of my favorite health tools, and food, one of my favorite activities, and how to combine those two to be an amazing fat burner. Sounds pretty cool, right? I'm gonna show you exactly how you can do it. So those of you that are new to my channel, just wanna say welcome. I'm a woman on a mission. I want the whole world to fall in love with fasting. But I also, women out there, it is time for us to take our power back, for us to learn how to eat according to our hormones so we can start to shine and we can start to be incredibly healthy. We deserve it. So if you're new, just hit the subscribe button and the notification bell and let's dive into this video.
Fasting. Do a long fast one day, your blood sugar going up and down. We're in it together.
Okay, so here's what I want you all to get. And I hope if you've been watching my videos for a while, you understand this. We love fasting for so many reasons. And if you're new to fasting, I just want to say that you can equate fasting to time-restricted eating. So this is where you're going to take all your food and you're going to put it in a very concrete period of time. And there are six different fasts that I love. I mapped all these fasts out in Fast Like a Girl, my new book that's coming out. It is available for pre-order right now. If you just put pre-order in the comments, my team will send you a link and we have a whole free course based off of that book that you can actually access now. So when I look at being able to compress this eating window, there are six different ways, time lengths that you want to lean into depending on what you're trying to create in your body. On this video, I'm going to talk about the time lengths of fasting that work really well for fat burning. But I got this food in front of me because I also want you to know how to lean into food to become an amazing fat burner. And with that idea, I am going to teach you in this video a concept called protein cycling. And those of you that are vegetarian, don't turn the video away. I've got some really good news about some vegetarian protein-rich foods that you can have as well. It's the concept of protein cycling that I really, really want you to grasp because it's in protein cycling that we can really start to become amazing fat burners. So let's start with this principle. I say this on almost every video. I have a whole chapter on it in Fast Like a Girl. And it's called metabolic switching. If you want to lose weight, you need to metabolically switch. In fact, the chapter on metabolic switching in Fast Like a Girl is, I refer to it as the missing key to weight loss. So when we go to lose weight, up until now, what we've been doing is we start to restrict calories. We start to change our food. And that we think that is the only way of losing weight. But how many of us have done that? Where we have manipulated our food, lost weight, only to have it come back. So I want to teach you protein cycling because that will never happen if you learn the art of protein cycling. Now, the other part of metabolic switching and using it to lose weight is we've got to master fasting. And we know that your body starts to go after its glucose stores, its hormone stores, its toxic stores. It starts to burn more fat when we start to compress our eating window, leaving at least 13 to 15 hours of time within our day without eating. That's called fasting. Now, if you go 17 hours, you're gonna get a deeper reaction and more healing. If you go 24, you're gonna get more, 36 more, 48 more. I'll show you how this all works in a moment. But if we wanna be a really good fat burner, we've got to learn how to work with the sugar burner system, and we got to learn how to tap into the fat burner system and pair them together. That is the art of metabolic switching. So today, protein cycling is your go-to food to be able to upregulate this fat burning piece of the equation. Let me explain how. For starters, when you eat protein, you are going to build muscle. Bottom line. The more muscle you have, the faster your metabolism will be. The faster this sugar burner metabolism will be. When you have more muscle, you have more insulin receptors. So when you eat food, you are going to up, your glucose will go up, your insulin will go up, and you'll have more receptors because you have more muscle to be able to pull all that glucose and insulin into the cells. So we want more muscle to be able to bring all that glucose and insulin into the cells so that the cells can use them for energy. So when we look at building muscle through diet, there is only one macronutrient that will work for that, and that is protein. And there is only one way you can go after getting those insulin receptor sites to open up and to create more muscle, and that is protein cycling, and it works like this. You want to start with this idea that you are going to get as much protein into your diet as you want your weight to be. So let me give you an example. I'm happy when I'm at 130 pounds. I'm gonna talk in pounds. I know we have a worldwide community, but I'm gonna talk in pounds right now. So when I'm at 130 pounds, that's my comfort level. I love being at that place because I know I can be muscular and I can be lean at that weight. So that means I need to eat 130 grams of protein a day in my eating window. But I don't want to eat that all at once, because if I want to trigger these amino acid sensors in the muscle to build more insulin receptors to invite the glucose and insulin in, I need to divvy that 130 up into at least 30 gram chunks. You need to at least get 30 grams per meal. So I want to show you what that looks like, because this is one of the biggest questions I get is, well, how do I know what 30 grams is? So I'm going to go through some of my favorite proteins, and we'll talk a little bit about some vegetarian proteins as well. So for starters, let's start with steak, grass-fed steak, my favorite. What we know about grass-fed steak is that it is 1 ounce of steak is 7 grams of protein. So just to give you an eyeball, this is a 10 ounce steak, which would then be, this would be 70 grams. So you would be way over your 30 gram increment, but let's use me as an example, I would also be moving closer to getting my 130 grams for the day. So this would be an amazing thing for me to eat, to build muscle, to increase insulin sensitivity. Okay, so that's the first thing. An egg. I love eggs. These suckers are not rich in protein. There's 6 grams of protein per egg. So if you got to hit that 30 gram sensor site, receptor or sensor in the muscle, you're going to need to have at least 5 of these in one sitting to be able to start to see that muscle grow and increase glucose or increase insulin receptivity in the muscle. Now, what about chicken? Also, 7 grams of protein per ounce. So when you look, whether it's a breast or it's a thigh, we need to look at making sure that you're getting at least, you would need somewhere around 5 ounces to make sure you hit your 30 gram sensor. Do you get where I'm going with this? So each bit of protein doesn't have the equal amount of total protein. So you're gonna need to lean into more of your chickens and more of your beefs over your eggs. Now, interesting enough, I did some research. Yogurt, this isn't Greek yogurt, but Greek yogurt has some of the highest amount of protein. Check this out. So Greek yogurt has 12 to 18 grams of protein for 5 ounces. So if you do dairy, that's a great choice. Let me tell you another great protein-rich food, lentils. So this is those of you who are vegetarian. Lentils have 7 grams of protein per ounce. So a bag like this has got, let's see if it's gonna tell me how many ounces. It has got 5 ounces in this bag. So this whole bag here would be about 35 grams of protein. So I'd want to use the whole bit to get to that amino acid sensor. So you can see how this all works. We've got my friendly fish here. We have got Nut butter, I like to use nut butters that are lower in oxalates, so the walnut butter is great. I like it raw. Pecan butter is great. Almond's gonna be higher in oxalates and lectins, so I like to stay to the lower amounts. You can lean into bone broth. I mean, you can lean into jerky. Check this out. I didn't know this till I started researching for this video. Jerky, 1 ounce of dried jerky has 10 to 15 grams of protein. That's insane. So your options are vast. You just need to realize that if you wanna lose weight, you gotta eat more protein and you gotta eat 30 grams per meal. And you've got to make sure that you're eating a 1 gram per every body weight you want to be. Go back and re-listen to that. If you didn't catch that, go back and re-listen to it. It is that important. So when we want to be a better fat burner, protein cycling, where we're going in with protein in these 30 gram chunks, getting to our total ideal weight in grams, that's amazing. That is, you're gonna not only build muscle, but you're gonna make this system more efficient. You're gonna open up insulin receptor sites and you're gonna speed up your metabolism. Your total metabolism will improve. Now pair that with something like a 17-hour fast. When you pair it with a 17-hour fast, remember at 17 hours we stimulate autophagy. Autophagy is where these dysfunctional cells get washed away. We call them senescent cells. So now I know what you're thinking. You're like, well, if I need to get to 130 grams of protein and I've only got a short window to eat them, then I'm gonna have to eat a lot. This is very true. So when we go to be intentional about losing weight through protein cycling and timing it with the longer fast, once that window opens, you gotta eat. And you could do 30 grams of protein every hour, every 2 hours inside that eating window. Last thing I wanna tell you, those of you that are vegetarian, when we look at some of the plant-based proteins, especially in the protein powders, sometimes we don't use, our glucose will literally go higher when we're drinking our protein as opposed to masticating our protein and chewing our protein. This was part of a beautiful conversation that I had with Dr. Boz. You can go listen to that. So if you are worried about glucose being too high, insulin being too high, and you're doing a lot of plant-based smoothies, you might want to move over to doing more lentils and more things where you're actually chewing so that you can improve insulin and glucose sensitivity. But it's really a chemistry game. Do you guys get that? This is what we're doing. It is a total chemistry game. So that's how you start to become this amazing fat burner. And once you click in and once you've got yourself in that position where you're bringing in the protein, you're doing it in this protein cycling way, and you're timing it with something like a 17-hour fast, now you're gonna watch the weight drop off. I promise you, I've seen it happen to hundreds and thousands of people, especially women. I know you out there, I know we get stuck with our weight, and this is going to be your ticket out, I promise you. 17-hour fasting with protein cycling, boom, you're gonna become the best fat burner you can possibly be. So as always, I hope that helps. Very detailed. There's a lot of nuance in this video. Please go watch it again if you didn't catch all of that. Share this out into the world. And I can't wait to get Fast Like a Girl into your hands. So just hit pre-order on your comments and my team will come and send you a link and show you how not only can you pre-order it, but you can get a free course that I've done so that you can start applying the principles of the book now. Don't give up on yourself. Whatever you do, please don't give up on yourself. And if you've used protein cycling before, we're a community. Tell your story in the comments. We want to hear your win. So hope that helps.